Scottish police fail to investigate 40 avoidable deaths in troubled health board. Police Scotland has now confirmed that detectives did not seek any independent evidence or interview any witnesses following a report of potential criminality at NHS Ayrshire and Arran. Former nurse Rad Wilson contacted the former Strathclyde police in 2013 after he uncovered an attempt to bury a string of damning reports into hospital deaths. He believed there was evidence of criminal negligence as bosses had not acted to correct failings, leading to the same deadly mistakes being repeated. However, police and prosecutors decided there had been no crime after examining two reports, one carried by the NHS watchdog and another commissioned by the health board itself. The weakness of the original investigation was first exposed in August, when we revealed the findings of a review by Kate Frame, the Police Investigations and Review Commissioner, PIRC. Although Ms. Frame only looked at the force's handling of a complaint by Mr. Wilson, she ordered Police Scotland to explain why officers had failed to obtain independent evidence. Chief Superintendent Paul Main of Ayrshire Division has now written, stating, "Detective Inspector A received a report from you concerning a series of deaths where the deceased were within the care of NHS Ayrshire and Arran. Detective Inspector A was appointed the Senior Investigating Officer, CEO. It became clear to him at the preliminary stages of this investigation that a review of the processes and policies had been conducted by independent auditors PricewaterhouseCoopers and a Scottish Government-commissioned review by Healthcare Improvement Scotland. It was as a consequence of these two detailed reviews from separate sources that the CEO thought it appropriate not to seek further independent evidence or to interview any witnesses. Instead, a report of the circumstances and available information was provided to the Crown Office and Procurator Fiscal Service, COPFS, seeking instruction and direction. For clarity, I should state that this submission to COPFS was not a prosecution report and was never considered to be such." Mr. Wilson and former healthcare regulator Roger Livermore, from the Action for of Safe and Accountable People's ASAP NHS campaign, met with Police Scotland to discuss the case last week. They have now written to Acting Chief Constable Ian Livingston to request that he call in an outside force to examine the force's handling of the long-running saga. A letter from ASAP NHS states, "It remains that Strathclyde Police and now Police Scotland have failed to investigate the serious adverse event reports at Ayrshire and Arran involving over 40 suspicious deaths. The basics of policing to detect, investigate, prosecute, and prevent crime have not been achieved. Accordingly, the investigation of the 40 deaths needs to be now referred to an independent police force." Mr. Livermore said the Scottish Police Authority and Justice Secretary Michael Matheson had the legal powers to call in an outside force to investigate Police Scotland. Last year, Chief Constable Phil Gormley asked Durham Constabulary to carry out a probe into the police spying role linked to the investigation of the 2005 murder of Emma Caldwell. A Police Scotland spokeswoman said, "We acknowledge the outcome of the Police Investigations and Review Commissioner's Complaint Handling Report and have responded to Mr. Wilson in regard to the PIRC's recommendations. In discharging one of these recommendations, we met with Mr. Wilson this week to gather further information. As indicated in our correspondence with Mr. Wilson, it remains our position that the report and documents submitted to COPFS were sufficient to enable a decision to be made on the matter, and no further investigation has been instructed. Additionally, PIRC have not directed further investigation."